Nintendo's plan for 2025 has seemingly leaked. Many people have wondered how Nintendo will continue to support the original Switch console past the successor launch. But I think we now know what Nintendo will do to keep things rolling for both the Switch and the Switch 2. Traditionally, Nintendo fans look forward to one new first-party Switch game each calendar month. But this actually won't be possible for the Switch in 2025, when Nintendo's focus will be on the Switch 2. And not everyone's going to get a Switch 2 when it comes out. So how is Nintendo going to keep Switch 1 players happy? The answer is in remasters. We already know about Donkey Kong Country Returns HD coming out in January, and now Xenoblade Chronicles X coming out in March. But what about February and beyond March? I'm sure that we'll still get a few games that will release for both the Switch and the Switch 2 at the same time, like how we've heard that Metroid Prime 4 Beyond will release for them both, but Nintendo doesn't typically release games for multiple consoles when their next device comes out. They usually focus heavily on the newest device they have. So those double releases of the same game for two consoles will be few and far between. Now, if we're going to rely on remasters to keep titles pumping out onto the Switch, do we already know what other remasters we should look forward to? We probably do, but let's back up a little bit. Xenoblade Chronicles X seemed to come out of nowhere without any warning of its announcement, but it actually was hinted at beforehand by Puro. As I've mentioned in other videos, Puro's track record of leaks have been flawless. Before Xenoblade Chronicles X was announced, Puro's recent profile change on X to Looking Eyes were thought to have meant that he was talking about the Switch 2 being revealed soon, since Looking Eyes were also used when Playtonic posted about their remastered game, Yuka Replay League, being released for Nintendo's next console. But we've come to find out that Puro was actually more sneaky than we could have imagined. His hint was actually given from the top of his page's profile, where, when it's combined with X's back arrow and the X logo to the left of it, Puro was actually talking about Xenoblade Chronicles X coming out soon. He clarified this when Miguel Parra questioned him about it, and Puro let him know that it happened an hour ago, just 1 hour after Xenoblade Chronicles X was announced. In addition to this, he also said, "There's a little more." Well, what more could there be? Another leaker, Samus Hunter, who's been correct on her last two leaks, said, "Everyone is eagerly awaiting the reveal of the Switch successor. But get ready, because before its launch, Nintendo has many more titles planned for the first console." What more titles could Puro and Samus Hunter be talking about? PH Brazil next chimes in with more of a perspective on this, on his YouTube video that I have a link for in the description. A summary of his video was written up by Gaming Leaks and Rumors with the following. Nintendo is courting third-party devs to do remasters on Switch 1 to make it for Nintendo's own teams being busy with Switch 2. Brazil reiterates what he previously said about remasters for a GameCube game and a 3DS game, though he didn't say which games. But he also mentioned some third-party games that'll get remasters on Switch 1 in 2025 as part of an initiative from Nintendo to court third parties and help compensate for Nintendo's own internal teams being too busy with the Switch 2. These games include Ubisoft, Splinter Cell Blacklist, Rayman 3, not connected to the rumored Rayman remake by Ubisoft Milan, Driver 1 and 2, potentially Driver SF down the line, two more unnamed titles under consideration, EA, additional Wii games, Bandai Namco, multiple projects, from a big Western third-party publisher, two re-releases. Brazil specifically mentioned that this initiative is to make sure Switch 1 owners who don't immediately upgrade to Switch 2 still have some new things to play while Nintendo is focused on Switch 2. This doesn't necessarily mean the system is further out than most expect. So, not only will there be first-party Nintendo remastered games, but Nintendo is also getting third-party publishers to join the bandwagon of remastering games for the Switch in 2025. Going back to the article in this section, PH Brazil talks about Nintendo remastering a GameCube game and a 3DS game. What could those games be? As crazy as this gaming news is, another crazy thing you can do is hit the like and subscribe buttons. Come on, what are you not doing yet? You know you like these videos. Nate the Hate on YouTube, or Nate Drake on Family Boards, gives more clarification on the 3DS game PH Brazil hinted at. In response to someone asking about what game it was, Nate says, "Yes, a 3DS game is being ported to Switch. We've discussed this release for several months. Funny thing is, the game has been mentioned many times over the year in various ways." What 3DS game has been talked about many times over the year in various ways? The one 3DS game that fits this description that comes to my mind is Kid Icarus Uprising. Masahiro Sakurai, who's best known as the creator of Kirby and Smash Bros., also directed Kid Icarus Uprising, which came out on the 3DS. On at least three different occasions this last year, once on X and twice on his YouTube channel, Sakurai talked about the possibility of Kid Icarus Uprising being put on another platform outside of the 3DS. There have also been job listings at Bandai Namco to work on projects that Nintendo has commissioned for remastering a 3D action game. I would think that Kid Icarus Uprising could be that game. And maybe that's the game Nate the Hate was referring to. Now let's talk about the GameCube game PH Brazil hinted at. With Metroid Prime 4 Beyond coming out next year, and us already having Metroid Prime 1 remastered for the Switch, you would think that Nintendo would want us to get the backstory to Metroid Prime 4 by remastering Metroid Prime 2 and 3 as well. Rumors about these games getting remastered in a potential double pack have been going around for a long time now, and if there ever was a time for this to happen, now would be the time. But I don't think those will be the only GameCube remastered games we're going to get. Two other GameCube games have also been talked about for a long time now that more than likely will be remastered for the Switch. And seeing how Nintendo announced that they are remastering a game that's almost 10 years old now with Xenoblade Chronicles X, hope has been restored for many more older games to be remastered. The two GameCube remastered games that have been in the rumor mill for so long that most people have given up on are none other than Zelda Wind Waker and Zelda Twilight Princess. Though these beloved games were technically remastered already to their HD counterparts for the Wii U, we all know how much of a failure the Wii U was and that most people never got the chance to play them in HD. Also, multiple sources have claimed that Nintendo has already remastered these games for the Switch and that Nintendo's just waiting around for the right time to drop them. This transitional time to a new console is the best time for them to come out. The Legend of Zelda franchise has never disappointed me. And out of all the remake possibilities, these are the ones I personally would love to see the most. Aside from Smash Bros. Melee, The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker and The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess are my favorite games from the GameCube and deserve a remaster or remake, much like Smash Bros. Has already received. Now, not only will there be remasters for the Switch, but it sounds like the Switch 2 will get a 4K remaster of its own in The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild from the Switch. Hopefully it's a definitive edition with all the DLCs and some extras too. I don't think remasters will go away anytime soon. There have been many amazing games in the past that with the help of a little graphic and sound quality boost would be just as enjoyable if not more so now on more modern consoles than they were on in the past. Nintendo knows this and I believe they'll keep titles going strong by revisiting and revitalizing their many Grand Slam games of the past. This will keep Nintendo fans happy and thirsty for more no matter what generation console they're enjoying them on. That's why I believe Nintendo will keep support going strong for the Switch even after the Switch 2 comes out. What are your thoughts? Do you agree or disagree with my thoughts on how Nintendo will support the Switch when the Switch 2 comes out next year? Are there other remasters or ways you believe Nintendo will keep supporting the Switch going forward? Leave a comment and let me know. If you like this video, you're going to love this one too.